On the phone with us, one of the best trainers in boxing, Henry Ramirez. You can follow him on Instagram at Riverside Boxing. He's out of Riverside, California. Yesterday, you were in Los Angeles for the Golden Gloves, and you've been, since you were a kid, you went to hundreds of amateur events. I've never seen anything like it. Describe what happened yesterday at this, with this brawl broke out.
Okay, so, during the course of the evening, first of all, the event started late. It started about 2 hours late for the doctor getting whatever. So we have the 15th bout. So the 11th bout is up, and, we're up in the bleachers kind of just hanging out. And as the fight started coming to an end, a close fight, I don't really remember who was winning. Final bell rings. And a punch was landed, right at the bell or maybe a tick later, but it didn't seem with anything malicious intended. Well, the other fighter responded back, adrenaline, hey, fighters. And the other fighter responded back, landed a punch. The other guy landed the punch at the bell, landed the punch back, and it went back and forth, and then it escalated to gestures, the woman referee trying to break it up. And it turned in Ellie to a full-scale riot, bro. There was probably, I'm going to guess, at least 25 people that jumped in the ring for maybe supporters of each, and it just escalated. It was pretty wild.
While you're recording this on your phone, first you thought it was like, what are you watching? And then it sunk in what's going on.
Yeah, well, like I said, you see the guys fighting and the ref trying to break it up, and it was a woman. I think she got thrown to the ground, and then you see it looked like a bunch of ants just swarming in the ring. I'm like, oh, so I just grabbed my phone and started recording, And I seen the one that went to TMZ Sports. It was a different angle, and I'm like, man, I got a lot better video than that.
I saw chairs flying, but in amateurs, you don't really see it get that heated, do you?
No, usually not, but you know what it is, Ellie? I mean, it's still boxing, and people sometimes let their emotions get the best of them, and, It was actually the referee, Ray Corona's son, who was fighting. So professional referee Ray Corona's son was fighting. So, it was crazy. It took a while to restore order. Once they cleared the ring, it looks like they were almost going to go at it even outside. It took a while.
Did you go back today?
No, I was okay. So I have a guy who advanced to Friday, and I have four fighting Friday, one Saturday, but we just found out this evening that they pushed everything back a day on the tournament. I'm not sure if it was for whatever reason, but the whole tournament got pushed back. So all the fights that were supposed to be today got pushed back for tomorrow. Friday's got pushed. So
you know why? Because all the local cameras and all the reporters run over there at Lincoln Park with, like, so they wanted to, like, hey, it gives boxing a black eye.
It really does, especially amateur boxing. Amateur boxing, it's considered the purest form of the sport, I guess, if you want to. But it escalated pretty quickly last night.
We've all seen riots in Argentina. We've seen riots in Mexico. It's the first riot I've seen in an L.A. boxing ring, professional or amateur, that I can remember.
Yeah, I don't remember seeing anything like that. It was pretty crazy. It escalated pretty quick. Like I said.
But Henry, let me ask you this. So you have a fight. Do you think at this point, like, your fight's canceled? Like, the event's over? They're going to kick
You know what's funny, Ellie? They actually were able to restore some kind of order, brought both guys to the center of the ring and announced that they were both disqualified, which, seemed fair. And during the course of them brawling, they were threatening. The guy on the PA, they were actually threatening to cancel the rest of the fights. They were that was a real threat. And at that point, that was about 11. There were still 8 or 9 more guys fighting. Mind you, Ellie, this event started 2 hours late. And by the time this went on, it was probably, I want to say, close to 10:30, maybe, because by the time I got out of there, it was about midnight after our fight.
Yeah, no, it was supposed to start at 7. I guess it started at 9, so that's really late. Yeah. So any advice for young fighters who watched what not to do, how not to get involved in a brawl?
I think what escalated it, to be honest, was just the corners jumping in. It was two guys had it stayed between the two combatants that, you know, obviously let their best of their emotions get the best of them after the fight, it probably would not have escalated. But people jumping in, and then it became fans who I'm sure were family members or friends of each side. And at that point, you know, all you're thinking about, I guess, really is just looking out for people you're concerned about, you know?
In your video that I saw that everybody's going to watch after this interview, was that the trainer Superman getting getting punched in the face in this corner of the ring, or is that somebody else?
You know who that is, man? That's actually Mike Franco. I didn't realize till the end who had actually. I had my phone up and was like just kind of watching everything. And I heard, like, I didn't realize who somebody had actually got punched like that. So I watched the video after. And then my fighter told me, "Hey, I think that's Mike Franco," and sure enough, it was. You know?
Wow. What would Henry Ramirez do if he was in the corner and someone swung at him like that?
Oh, man. You know, hey, Ellie, you know, I mean,
I'm joking. Point, you don't have to answer.
At a certain point, you know, you would hope cooler heads prevail. But honestly, if you get hit or somebody throws a punch at you, I mean, sometimes, you know, a man's got to do what a man's got to do sometimes.
But you know what's crazy, Henry, though, in amateur boxing, and you know this, the injuries are very light, very minor. It's usually very positive. It's a good experience. Of course, there are robberies, but that's the worst thing I've ever seen in amateur boxing is usually robberies, but nothing like this.
Yeah, that was pretty bad last night. You know, there was a clip where it shows or part of the clip, I think it shows a mom running with her small child.
Yes, that's true. Yep. I saw that.
And then I seen that other one where on my video, I didn't see where there was a different angle where the lady was hitting some dude in the back with the chair.
Yes. You know, I said Roma for Main Event. You know Roma from Glendale? He shot that. Roma for Main Events in Glendale.
That's crazy, man. You know, then it was an unfortunate incident. You know, hopefully it doesn't happen again. And but you know, man, boxing, it was crazy. It was crazy.
Really quick, Henry Ramirez, you got 8 fighters you're working with, 2 turn pro. Tell us about him, and you have 6 more that are about to turn pro.
Okay, so this year, you know, one of the things I've been, you know, I also have an amateur program. So on Tuesday night, I came straight from the FS1 show, flew to Ontario, went straight to the Golden Gloves.
Stay right at the Golden Gloves.
Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Ellie Secback.